Welcome to NonstopNeuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Once upon a time inside the body, an award ceremony was going on, and different awards were given to different organs for the special role they play in the body. That day, an award called Resistance Vessel was given to arteries, and another award called Capacitance Vessels was given to veins. Well, you might already have heard these terms, but I'm pretty sure that you don't know all the factors that the judges took into account when deciding the winner. So allow me to surprise you with all the behind the scenes. The fundamentals are in two different properties of blood vessels: resistance and distensibility. In the video on the resistance of blood vessels, we saw that the resistance is inversely proportional to the radius of the vessel to the fourth power. There are two points to be inferred from this relationship. One, the resistance is in the denominator, means with an increase in radius, the resistance falls. And second, it's related to the fourth power, which multiplies the impact of radius. So in fact, even a small increase in radius causes a huge fall in resistance. In short, there is a drastic fall in resistance with an increase in the radius of the vessel. So that's one fundamental. Now, one of the factors affecting the radius is the distensibility of the vessels. So let's talk about the distensibility, which can also be referred to as compliance. The elastic nature of the vessel wall allows them to expand when the pressure inside their lumen increases. Now, the arteries have a thick and strong wall, so it's less distensible. This means even with a large increase in pressure, it does not expand much. On the other hand, the veins have thin walls. Moreover, at lower volumes, their lumen takes an ellipsoidal shape like this. So even with a small rise in pressure, the vein shows a huge distension. In short, the arteries show very small distension, even over a large pressure increase. And veins show more expansion even with a small increase in pressure. So this was the second fundamental concept. If we put everything together, this is the final picture for judges. For both arteries and veins, the upper side is the initial situation, and lower sides are situation after some increase in pressure. The values of all the parameters are presented in the form of the size of their symbols. And on the lower side, I have shown the initial sizes in very faint colors, if you can see them, for easy comparison. Don't confuse them with anything else. Now let's discuss the veins. They are more distensible. Even with a small increase in pressure, they distend so much. Or in terms of radius, there is a large increase in radius. Now the resistance is already related to the radius to the fourth power. And here we have a large increase in radius on top of that. So fall in resistance in veins happens like crazy. So definitely the award for resistance is not going to veins. But at the same time, this huge expansion of veins without much rise in pressure makes them ideal to store extra blood. Or in other words, you can say veins have a large capacity to hold blood. So for this, the veins are given the award of capacitance vessels. Now come to arteries. They are less distensible, which means they don't expand much, even with a marked rise in pressure. As they don't expand much, their radius does not increase as fast. Yes, the fourth power is applicable here also. But remember basic math. The power multiplies the impact of the base. But here, the radius is showing minimal change. So without much change in the base, even the fourth power cannot produce much impact. So arteries continue to provide high resistance even with increasing pressure. Of course, there is a little bit of fall in resistance here too. But compare it with veins. Veins gave up on resistance too easily at small pressure rises. But arteries, they don't give up on providing resistance even at high pressure. And that earned them the award of resistance vessels. So that's the exact reason why arteries are called resistance vessels, and veins are called capacitance vessels. Before summary, if you are enjoying this video, you might want to visit my website, nonstopneuron.com, which is the best place to explore my entire library of more than 250 amazing animation videos, explaining medical concepts in a fun and easy way. If you don't watch them, you are missing a lot. Now, summary. The veins expand much, even at slight pressure changes, that they can hold large quantities of blood at low pressure. So they are called capacitance vessels. Arteries, on the other hand, don't expand much and continue to provide high resistance, even with a marked increase in pressure. So they are called resistance vessels. For sticking with me until the end, I have an award point for you, too. One of the reasons for the fourth power of radius is the laminar flow of the blood. In this, the fastest flowing layers of blood are at the center. As a vessel constricts, it's the fastest flowing streams from the center that are lost, and only the slowly flowing stream close to the vessel wall remains. So there is a huge resistance increase, even with a small fall in radius. Don't forget to visit the website where I have more award videos for you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.